Part 3. My Season in Hell. By the time I was 21 years old and worn down to the bone, the battered woman syndrome had come full circle in my relationship with Dick. I was working full-time and paying most of his bills, still getting over my father's death, receiving regular beatings by this fucking psychopath, who at this point I was staying with out of fear more than any other motivation. As the holidays approached, the camel's back finally started to crack. First off, when Dick and I exchanged gifts on Christmas Day, he had in plain view of me this enormous Victoria's Secret bag that held a Santa sack full of lingerie, while his present for me was so small you could have fit it comfortably into a fucking brown lunch bag. On top of that, when he took me to his family's house, he pretty much ignored or insulted me the whole time in front of his family. He wouldn't even hold my hand. So needless to say, that holiday was awful. My mom wasn't that much help, and I didn't have my father, so I almost felt entirely alone. When New Year's Day came, the hell was finally raised. Dick basically blew me off New Year's Eve to go out to some strip club with his friends, ended up hooking up with some gutter snatch named Barbara, who he ended up leaving me for the very next day. In fact, he's actually married to her to this day. The biggest irony about that one was that for all the shit he gave me for dancing and liking clubs, he met Barbara at a strip club. What frustrated me about the whole way the breakup went down was that I had no closure. All he basically said to me was, "Yo, maybe we shouldn't see each other anymore." So we didn't talk for like a week after that. And finally, he told me to come over and pick up my things. So, stupidly hoping there might be a final chance for things to work out, plus in an attempt to get my things back, I went all the way out to New Jersey in a snowstorm, and he wasn't even home. The motherfucker stood me up. And to top it all off, leaving, I had a nasty spill down a steep icy hill and almost broke my fucking head open. I knew he was at home too. He just wasn't answering the door. He left me with nothing. I couldn't even take our little kitten. He was gray with little white paws for comfort. It was a fitting ending. I went into his van on my way back and found all of these love notes from Barbara. So it was obvious they'd been seeing each other before New Year's Eve. Looking back on it now, I count myself lucky. Because if I had married him, I never would have lived out the whole set of wild adventures I had in my late 20s, and my life would have been horrible. I would have ended up a battered Jersey housewife. 2 weeks after that, my mom and I started getting all these notices in the mail about the tickets for his child molester van, and I told my mom that I had the van in my name. So, my mom called Dick and demanded he pay the tickets, which he refused to do. So, she had his van towed in immediate retaliation, since it was in my name. But the satisfaction was only fleeting. He called my mom after that and told her I was dancing, which I was able to refute, thankfully. I guess I did have some natural ability as a litigator, because I had to pull off a Perry Mason-sized moment to convince her that he was lying. Dick left me raped financially and emotionally, with my spirit beaten down to a point that I could hardly recognize myself inside anymore. Everything that my mother had raised me to be in terms of toughness, he'd beaten out of me, for the moment anyway. In addition to the emotionally shitty shape I was in, the aftermath of our breakup financially was even worse, because he'd stopped paying the bills on credit cards he made me take out for him in my name. Student loans, his van payments, the fucking works. So, I was dancing primarily at that time to pay off those debts, and I'm talking about thousands and thousands of dollars. I was paying off that debt to this day. We'd been together for 5 fucking years, and they were to date the most hellacious years of my life. I'm slowly earning back my pride in the pages of this book. With that said, I'm not above admitting I've dreamt for years that Dick would die a slow and violent death, and that his soul would burn in some form of eternal hell and damnation. But it never came.